I think the project like really highlights as a parallel personal story and a universal story, how the African child navigates their purpose, you know, and I think that we do quite a lot of it aligning with our ancestors, aligning with who came before us. Chatting all things Folklore Chapter to Ekuseni with Pilani Bubu, who is a storyteller, a singer, songwriter, TV presenter, founder and director of the Folklore Festival. Pilani Bubu, thank you for having me. I'm Poppy Ntshongwana. Let's chat everything Folklore Chapter 2. So let's talk about that, your grandfather and the gifts in your family. What are those gifts? And tell me how you've connected everything to make sense in this project.
Sure. There is a big inquiry that I make in the project about whether ngamakhwalo or amabele. Amabele, my mom's side of the family. Mm-hmm. And that comes as a long line of abantu abathwasileyo and sangomas.
Okay.
My mom's parents were bebetwasa and they're healers, but then the church came into this kind of space and somehow they navigated differently than my mom watwasa. Translation subtitles with being initiated to become a healer. And you know, they my mom also works quite a lot in dreams and stuff. We're not in the day awakened, conscious, prophetic word,
okay.
I think.
Okay.
I think we're more like intuits and dreamers. And so this is something that's just been in my family actually for generations,
sure.
You know, and I'm very comfortable with this because my mom's walked her journey and seen her parents walk this journey.
Sure.
She has been unafraid of telling us stuff that may seem superstitious sometimes because it's very hard to kind of grapple with, you know, for someone who doesn't understand, haven't lived it. And I also feel my time in the Eastern Cape was always this like duality of like scary things and real things, just understanding how not just spirituality, but just like the idea of magic and witchcraft and the existence of all kinds of other, I suppose, what do they call them?
I guess it is spirituality.
In some way, right? It's good and bad.
Yeah.
And so I've also been unafraid to kind of talk of things, to see things differently. I've seen ghosts, I've seen things, do you know?
Yeah.
Do you see what I'm saying? And I think it has to do with an openness.
Yeah.
So I come from a very open, vulnerable family.
Sure.
And I think that's part of the gift, do you know? So yeah, that's kind of the story within the family. My dad's side, ngamakhwalo.
Okay.
So because now my grandfather always appears as my guardian, he named me Pilani. Heal, live, be well. And his nickname was Umntan'eThongo. That's one of the names. Umntan'eThongo, an ever abundant stream of life,
sure.
A wellspring of life. And I found that everything he said about me that everyone would regurgitate back to me came to life and manifest, do you know? And so there are these concepts of like, we are ancestors' wildest dreams. And that's kind of essentially what's also embedded in the story. And some of the songs like Umntan'eThongo, do you know? And in Vusumuzi, which is one of the songs, we should kind of find a chronological order in a bit. After this ceremony that I had to go through, I kind of asked both clans, who's going to accept these songs? Whose songs are these? Makwalo na mapele vumaningo mazenu. Makwalo na mapele vumaningo mazenu. And that time we're in the chant, do you know? But I somehow, through the connection I have with my grandfather and my dad, I call them the great man and the good man, these beautiful spirits, these giants, do you know? I kind of then sing about amakhwalo. It could be the patriarchal essence that I have. It could be the patriarchal essence in the ritual as well, of where your umbilical cord is buried. But then I do sing the clan praise, yamakhwalo. As if to say, this must be Kwalo's songs. These must be kwalo gifts. But I must tell you, the beles are very strong songbirds. Also, bando novuiswa and their kids and they love my aunt's front row Anglican church in Umtata spelt out the highest soprano in harmony. Do you know? And like lovers of the church and God.
And music. Musicality. Yeah. I think your family is known for that. Yeah. I don't think there's one person in that family. Is there someone in your family who can't sing? Everyone's got to give.
There's a couple of people within our immediate family that need a bit of training.
But you make up for them. You guys are a special, special family. So I'm glad that you're celebrating your gift in this. Umalandelwa zintombi zithi ndizeke usukude jisese.